today we have with us the founders of ZARR, Ms. Apoorva, Palak and Shivani. Welcome to the show, ladies.
Thank you, Samira. We are so glad we could make it.
You are all still in your 20s and have a successful business to yourself. And I must say, all your ZARR products are breathtaking.
Thank you so much. It took a lot to make ZARR what it is today.
I am sure. So, Palak, please tell the listeners as to how you came up with ZARR.
God, it's a long story. You know, I was always extremely fascinated with the lavish lifestyle of the Nawabs. Be it the Nizams from Hyderabad or the Nawab of Awadh. The stories you'll get to hear about them will send shivers down your spine.
God, yes. Do you know the Nizam Mir Osman used a 184-carat diamond as his paperweight, and not only that, he was the fifth richest person recorded in the history. He had a total sum of 210 USD billion.
The Begums especially wore Mukesh embroidery clothes done with real gold wires.
Okay, that's a lot. What a lavish lifestyle he must have had. Anyway, Apoorva, you mentioned something about the Mukesh Badla workers from Lucknow. What about them?
Oh yes, when all of us were visiting Lucknow, we stumbled upon these clan of workers who were called the Badla workers. So these were the people who used to make clothes for the Nawabs and their Begums.
What? They still exist?
We meant the same clan but a different generation. But the existing generation doesn't plan on passing on the skill. These workers are now in their late 60s and 70s. Unfortunately, they haven't passed on the skill to their children for the sole reason that this job doesn't pay well.
Yeah, they're hardly paid 200 bucks a day for such a strenuous job.
That's so sad. I am sure this was one reason that motivated you to take up the actual real gold Mukesh Badla work out of all the other so many hundreds of crafts that are going to extinct.
Yes, exactly. This was one very big reason as to why we wanted to revive this craft. We, being the youth of our country, should shoulder the responsibility to revive arts that make us so proud and have been a part of our heritage for such a long time.
I totally agree. I think there has been a huge change in the youth of today's time. With the kind of awareness there is now, people have started caring and actually giving a damn. And important issues like these are getting their due importance. Tell me one thing, has ZARR employed these Badla workers?
Of course we have. The kind of intricacy that is needed in our products can only be done by someone as experienced and hardworking as them.
In order to keep the art alive, we are planning on opening a training center in Lucknow itself where people who think can attempt this art and can learn the same from Badla workers.
That's really, really thoughtful of you all.
Our love for history, respect and admiration for the art brought ZARR to us. And of course, there was nothing like it in the market, so we saw it as an amazing opportunity.
I wish all of you the very, very best for the adventures to come. May you sail through the storms with success. It was wonderful to have all of you on the show.
Thanks for having us, Samira. It was a pleasure.
Stay tuned for more such success stories on Radio Pearl.